Well, let's do it for you instead. Okay. So reach out, just grab one. Which one do you want? But, here. Make the selection a little bit fairer. Which one? That one? Okay, cool. Got it? Yep. You can show. All right, cool. I don't actually have a Sharpie on me. I just realized I don't have a Sharpie. Oh, well. You'll just have to trust that that's the only card in the deck.
Okay. I have a regular pen.
No. Just place it back. I had to change tricks now, so this will go a little bit differently than I had planned, but it'll still work. Alright, cool. Do it like this. Fair shuffle. Happy. Alright, cool. Here's what I want you to do. Every single every single playing card in here has its own name, right? No two cards are the same, right? They all have their own unique identities, right? And, you know, much like with humans, if you were to call somebody over by name, they'd probably, you know, come to see you, right? So here's the idea. You are going to call your card by name, and it'll jump to see you.
Okay.
Go ahead. Call your...
The Ten of Diamonds.
That was your card?
Yep.
You sure? All right, let's see. Hey, it worked. All right, that's pretty cool, right?
Yeah.
But of course, you might think that I just had that on top and I was just, you know, goading you into picking the Ten of Diamonds. So, here's what we'll do. Stick it in the center. Push it in for me. Cool. Now, call it again.
Ten of Diamonds.
Let's see. It worked again. That's pretty cool, right? That's pretty slick. All right. Tell you what. Make it completely fair here, okay? Try this. We'll leave the Ten of Diamonds. Wait. Let's see. Center-ish, right? Cool.
Yes.
That's the Ten of Hearts. I'm not going to try and switch the two and get you confused or anything. So we'll actually put 10 over here, okay? Like this, okay? So, now, here's the idea.
Yes. How old is she?
Call it.
Ten of Diamonds.
Queen of Hearts. It might have misunderstood you. Wait.
She's 15.
Oh, it fell to the bottom. That's what happened. Okay.
Yep, she doesn't have to be 15 in 9 months. They can take
it. We'll do this one last time, and I want you to make sure that you're catching me and everything, okay? So, right there, no funny moves, right?
Starting at 11 o'clock through the summer.
Here's the idea.
From June up to August.
There's your card. Now watch
and night classes,
closely, and, like this.
Myself and Mr. Rubin were the teachers.
Do me a favor, push that in.
In the morning class.
Okay, now watch in the center of the center, so I can't possibly control it to the top, right? All right. Go ahead, call.
Ten of Diamonds.
King of Hearts. Okay. Call it one more time.
Ten of Diamonds.
Let's see if I can. You know what that's called?
No.
Misdirection.
Oh.
That's pretty cool, right?
Cool.
All right, let's do this. We'll try this. What's your name?
Eleanor.
Eleanor and?
Mary Jane.
Mary Jane, well, it's nice to meet you. My name's Timothy.
Timothy, okay. Nice to meet you.
We're going to do a card trick, like most of my tricks, okay? This is going to be a lot of fun, though. Would you like to pick the card? Okay, go ahead, just grab one, any one you like. Which one? That one?
Do I look at it?
Absolutely. It's your card.
That's
okay.
Right?
Yeah, well, you can look around and
all right.
See.
How about this? Do you guys want to see the trick as well?
Yeah,
okay, go ahead.
All right, go ahead. Here, I'm going to turn around. You can show them. Go ahead. Okay, got it? Okay, everyone's seen the card? Good? All right, here's the idea. I'll take the card, but I won't look, okay? Now, we'll put the card about center. Could you hold out your hand for me? Okay, good. Now put your other hand on top. Okay, good. Now, I can't possibly get to your card, somewhere in the center, right? But here, if you loosen up just a little, if I could grab out one card and that was your card, would that be amazing? All right, let's see.
Would be amazing.
Let's see.
He just grabbed that out.
But but that's not your card.
Nope.
That's also a very bad joke. Here, let me try again.
Okay.
Hey, let's see. Okay, wait. Is that your card? Okay, that was your, here. Put your keep your hand here. I got your card, but it was kind of like the second try, right?
So it wasn't all sorts of hearts.
It wasn't all that great. So tell you what, if I could make this card vanish before your very eyes, would that be a good trick? All right, watch. Like that. You'll never see the card again. It's amazing. Here, another bad joke. Tell you what. All right, here, this will actually be amazing. Watch. If I snap my fingers, you know what happens? The entire deck turns invisible. Go ahead.
Yeah.
Look, those are actual invisible cards. Look,
how
every
did you do that?
Single one. That's pretty cool, right?
It's very cool.
Uh-huh. Thanks for watching.
It's got an earring.
Huh? Yeah.
Yeah.
Now how do you put them back?
I've got another deck of cards in my pocket.
Good job.
Heat from my body. I was like, hi, come on. You weren't listening. Are you interested in doing it for anybody else?
Yes, happen to.
Do you have a card?
I do, actually.
Let's have a card.
Let's see.
We are with the American Legion. We do things for children down there.
Very cool.
So
I'd be happy to. Here you go.
Yes. Timothy Carver.
Yep. Okay. I'd be happy to help out and do that. It would be great.
Well, we have some things coming up.
So, okay.
We'll talk about it.
Okay. Well, thank you very much.
Thank you. It was very enjoyable.
Yes. My email is on the back. You can reach me that way. So it's very nice meeting you, too. Thank you.
Rachel,
it's Tim. Nice to meet you.
Good to meet you, too.
All right. We're going to try a card trick. This is one of my favorite card tricks, okay? Ready for this? Do you want to pick the card or would you like to?
Go ahead.
Okay. Reach out, just grab one. Any which one. Got it?
Yep.
Okay. Go ahead, look at it. Would you like to see this as well?
Sure.
Okay. Come on over and look at the card.
I'll look at the card.
Okay. All right. Good? You guys have it?
Yep.
All right. Cool. Now, the reason why this is one of my, here, you can put it back. The reason why this is one of my favorite tricks is because it's actually a mentalism trick. It's mind reading. You guys ever dabbled in that?
No.
Okay. Well, the idea is pretty simple. I want you to think of your card. Now, I have three people here. All, you know the card? You saw it? Okay, good. I want each of you to picture the card. This will make it easier for me to catch the signal. Okay. So think of the card. Yeah, there's some. Thinking of it? I don't know. I'm getting the impression it's a red card.
Maybe.
Okay. He doesn't want to give me too much. All right. It's a diamond.
Allegedly.
Oh, allegedly. Okay. Okay. All right. I'm gonna go for broke here. I'm getting the impression it was, he's the strongest signal. He's really entertained. Here, look at me. I want to say 10 of diamonds.
That was it.
That's pretty cool, right? But if I could actually teach you guys how to do that, that'd be amazing, right?
That would be really amazing.
Okay. So here's what we'll do. You seem the most enthusiastic about this. No, of course not, never. So here's what we'll do.
Just pretending.
Yeah, exactly. I'm going to actually teach you how to read your mind. Okay. Is that all right?
All right, here
okay.
we go.
Cool. So, here's the idea. I'm going to have you think of a card. All right. Say stop. We'll try again. That was just a bad force. All right.
Sorry.
Stop. Good? Are you happy there? Okay. Keep that in mind. That was for his eyes only. Did you catch that?
Nope.
Okay, good. Just making sure. All right. Here's the idea. Let's see. Seize up. All right. I'm going to try and teach you how to basically do what I did, read minds.
Ooh, that's going to be a good
trick. Are you right-handed or left-handed?
Right-handed.
Right-handed. Can I hold your right hand like this? All right.
Okay.
Cool. Look at me in the eyes.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. All right, here's the idea. We're going to try and establish a connection because I'm the one who knows how to read minds and you have no idea what I did.
No clue.
So, here's what we'll do. On three, I want you to name a number between 1 and 10, okay? So, I'm going to count down to 3. You're going to name a number between 1 and 10. Ready? 1, 2, 3, 7. You missed it, but okay.
I'll hear you say 8, but go ahead.
8, okay. Well, close. Not terribly far. All right, it might still work. If not, then that's okay. Could you step over here and you're on this side, so you're on my left side? That'll be perfect. All right. You're still thinking of a playing card, aren't you? Okay. Was it a... I don't want to give him anything, so we'll just try it this way. We have to establish a connection between you two now, okay? So, step a little closer. Look each other in the eyes, okay? All right, chin up just a little bit and look at him in the eyes, okay? Good? Got it? All right, now, hopefully you got a signal of what his card was, okay?
Mm-hmm.
Did you?
Oh, no.
No? All right. Look at each other in the eyes a little bit more. Keep your chin up. Good. Good. You got it? Okay. Let's hope this worked. Think of the card. Don't look at me. Look at him. He's the one reading minds. All right. Did you get it yet? All right. What is the card he's thinking of?
Seven.
Of?
Hearts.
Is that it? That's the one? It worked.
What was it?
Seven of hearts.
I was thinking of four hearts.
it was not far off.
That's awesome.
It was nice hanging out with you guys. Thanks.
Thank you, sir. Good job.
Appreciate thank you.
Take
nice
care,
meeting you.
It's good meeting you.
Yeah. Excuse me. You poor people look bored out of your minds. You guys look bored out of your minds. You want to see something? All right. All right.
Pick her.
All right, fine. I'll pick on you. Well, Mikey, I want to give you something not to tamper with, just to hold. This is a prediction, okay? This will be at the end of the effect, all right? Hold it your hand. Cool. Hold on to that for the duration of this show. It's going to be an hour, so. No, just kidding. All right. Cool. Just to prove that I can't touch that, I can't change my mind. He's got it. I can't do anything with that, okay? That'll be the end. But we'll do this. Let's see. What's your name?
Delaney.
Delaney. Okay. It's nice to meet you. I'm Tim. I'm his cousin.
Hi.
So, yeah, that's why I went over here. Delaney. Let's try something. Let's go with this card. I have a feeling this card's going to work. All right. Delaney, how good's your memory?
What?
How good's your memory?
Not very good.
Not very good. All right. Well, maybe this will work. Maybe this will help your memory, okay? All right. Are you right-handed or left-handed?
Right-handed.
Right-handed. Okay, you had to check. Which one? No, I'm just kidding. Do me a favor. Hold your hand like this. All right, open your thumb. Perfect. That's how you're going to be. And I'm going to hand you a card. What card is this?
The Six of Diamonds.
Okay, good. A lot of people get confused with playing cards. So do me a favor. Hold on to that. Now, if I were to do something funny like this, would you be able to remember what card that is?
Yeah.
What card is it?
The Six of Diamonds.
Okay, you sure?
Is it not the Six of Diamonds?
Well, you can check if you don't trust me. You don't trust me? I mean, come on, that's a little insulting. All right, tell you what. If it were just one card, it'd be really easy to remember, right?
Yeah.
So tell you what, we'll use two cards, all right? We'll use the Six of Diamonds and the Six of Hearts, okay? This is going to be my card, this is going to be yours,
okay?
The idea is simple. I'm going to switch it twice with your card. Watch, one, two, like that. Now you should have the Six of Diamonds.
Yeah.
See, I switched it and then I put it back. That's how fast I was.
Yeah.
You're not buying it?
No.
It's a little insulting. All right, tell you what. Here, if I switch it slowly, you'd be able to catch it, right?
Yeah.
Okay, so you've got the Six of Hearts, I got the Six of Diamonds. Tell you what. If I were to put this one on the bottom of this one, would you be able to remember which one's on top? A little wordplay there to confuse
it. The hearts is on top.
Yeah. You guys sure?
Yes.
Turn them over.
What the heck?
I guess your memory's not as good because we've been playing with the fours the entire time.
No, we haven't.
Yes, we have.
The sixes.
All right. Grab one. Which one? That one? Okay. Cool. Got it. Two of hearts. That's fine. Or two of diamonds, rather. All right, cool. Here's what we'll do. Put it back. This is going to be your card, okay? Now, keep in mind that every single playing card has a name, right? They all have their own names. They're all different. No two playing cards are exactly the same because, of course, suits, color, all this, you know. So here's what we'll do. We'll mix them up like this. And what I want you to do, Brittany, is just call your card by name, and it'll actually rise to the top. It'll actually come up to see you. Because if you were to call somebody, you know, hey, Mike, he'd probably turn around and come over, right? So we're going to do the same. No, not with this one.
Maybe another one.
But with playing cards, it always works. So call your card.
Two of diamonds.
See, it actually jumps. See? Not all that impressive. Every magician on the planet can do that trick. But only about half of them would actually repeat the trick. So here, put it in the center like this, so you can actually see it there, right? Okay, cool. Mix it up like this. Now, the thing is, because she picked the card, if you were to call the Two of Diamonds, it doesn't work. Go ahead, call the Two of Diamonds.
Two of Diamonds.
See, it doesn't work. It doesn't work like that. If you were to call the Two of Diamonds, however, go ahead.
Two of Diamonds.
See, it works. Just like that, right? Now we'll do it one last time, okay? I want you to make sure that you can actually catch it, okay? So here, look close. There's the two. Okay, you guys are really watching closely here. Watch. Look here. This. Right. There. Do me a favor, push that in. Okay, cool. Shit. Yeah, it was supposed to be. Well, it's a good thing I'm screwing up in front of my cousin, not some stranger. Here, we'll do it this way instead. You pick the two of diamonds. What are you doing? I said don't touch those.
But he doesn't listen very well. He doesn't listen.
No, he doesn't. Here, give them to me. I don't trust you. I'm done. All right, you pick the two of diamonds, right? Now, if I were to have come up here and told you that I made a prediction of which card you'd pick, you probably would have changed your mind 1,000 times, which is why I didn't tell you in the beginning. But I actually knew which card you'd pick. In this deck of cards, there's a two of diamonds. You guys not impressed? No. All right, what if I told you it was upside down from all the others? Proving that I knew which card you had, which card you would pick, the two of diamonds. I knew exactly which card you'd pick. Would you be impressed by that?
Kinda.
Yeah, that'd be cool, right? Here. Let's see.
Yeah, Mikey messed it up.
I hope you didn't, because this is not a cheap deck of cards. Two of diamonds, right? You see it? See it yet? I don't. Let's see. You're a little close, you know that? Alright, two of diamonds. Only card in the deck turned over. Let's hope this works. It's pretty cool, right? So, okay. I think I broke your girlfriend. Alright. You want to help with this?
No.
No? Okay. Here's the idea.
Okay.
I'm going to have you just pick a card, and we'll try and do something cool with it. So.
Do something cool with the card?
Yeah.
Alright, I got it right here.
Got it? Picked it?
Yep.
Good? I couldn't know what that card is, right?
Theoretically,
right. Here's what we'll do. Put it back. You do remember it, right?
I do remember it.
Okay,
I
good.
I should show it to her to make sure I don't lie.
Oh, well, that's okay now. Here's the idea. I'm going to try and do something cool with the cards.
Okay.
With your card in particular.
Okay.
All right?
Okay.
I'm going to take your card and actually render it invisible. And it's going to fly through the air and land in my pocket.
Okay.
A bold claim. But we'll try.
I do.
Here's the idea. What was your card?
You want me to tell you?
Yep.
Five of spades.
Five of spades. Okay. Watch. It's now invisible. It's no longer in the pack. Do you believe me?
No.
No, of course not. That's not your card. That's the five of clubs. Close. That's not your card. That's the ten of hearts, right?
Right.
Let's see. We've got... those aren't yours, right?
Nope.
No. All right, cool. None of these are yours, right?
Nope.
And this is just to prove that your card really is gone. It's not there. That's the five of hearts, but that's not your card, right?
Nope.
No. Okay. Let's see. None of these cards. That's the five of clubs, again.
Nope.
No?
Five of spades.
All right. Let's see. I'm trying to be as fair as possible. None of these.
Nope.
Nope. Of course not. Let's see. Here.
Nope.
No. I think we're going through just about the whole pack now. Any of these, that's the five of diamonds, but I don't see the five of spades. No.
Nope.
And then, no. That's it. And I told you... pocket, right?
Oh, yeah, in your pocket.
But it's still flying through the air.
Oh, yeah.
See, it's actually, while we've been doing that, it was circling the entire school.
Okay.
Three times. If you can believe that.
Yeah, I believe you. Yeah. You can put it.
And now it actually lands in the pocket. Look. Let's see. Your card was the five of
spades.
Five of spades. One card.
One card.
One card only.
How are you?
Five of spades. You're good.
Thank you.
That's good.
That's cool.
Very good.
Thank you. I'm actually going to put these cards away because I've got a prediction in my pocket here, all right? Let's see if I can bring it out. There we go. Here's my prediction, okay? I'm going to make the prediction, and hopefully it'll come true, okay? I'm going to turn around for a second and make my prediction. No one's supposed to see this. Here we go. Ready? Let's see. Okay. Okay. Good. Prediction has been made. What I did was I turned over one playing card in the deck. Just one.
One card? You turned over.
Yes. It is now upside down in the pack. Okay. Could you hold it your hand? Good. Just like that. Put your other hand on top. Good. So that I can't change my mind.
Alright.
Here's the idea. I want you to imagine for a moment as if I had a deck of cards in my hands.
Right.
Okay? Almost like an invisible deck of cards.
Right.
Okay? And I'd like you to imagine as if you could take one of these cards out and just hold it up.
Right.
Turn it over and put it back in the deck. Right?
Okay.
What is that card?
Ace of Spades.
The Ace of Spades. You sure?
Yep.
You can change your mind.
That's it.
That's it?
Yeah.
Alright, let's see. Ace of Spades. The one that's right here on the box.
That's it.
Watch. It'll actually turn over. Not a good effect, though. Now, here. If it were actually turned over, if it were the only one turned over in the deck, that would be amazing.
That'd be
unbelievable.
That would be
right? Absolutely astonishing. Look, right behind the queen here. Look, one card. One card out of the entire deck is over, right? And you picked the Ace of Spades, and you could have changed your mind. And yet the only card I turned over was the Ace of Spades. Nice
good
meeting
job.
You. Thank you. Thank you. Well, Miss Janet, we're going to try something using something that every woman's familiar with, woman's intuition. Okay? We're going to try this. Here's what I'd like you to do. Just pick one of the cards, anyone you'd like. Okay? Look at it. I'll turn away. Show everyone. Good? Okay. Yeah. Here's the idea. We'll place it back. Okay. You remember the card and you remember the card. Okay. Good. Now we're going to use woman's intuition to find that playing card. Okay? Here's the idea. I want you to get in touch with yourself and think for a moment of a number. Any number between, let's say, 1 and 30. Okay? What's the first number that pops in your head?
29.
Are you absolutely certain?
Not easy.
Yes. Okay. You don't want to change your mind? They never do.
No, they don't.
Except for about clothes and shopping and all that. They do that all the time. But anyway, 29. Here's the idea. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Oops. Let's see. That's number 7. Let's see. 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29. And you're absolutely certain that the 29th card is your playing card? Yes. Okay. For the first time, could you please name your playing card?
Name what?
Name your playing card. What was it?
10.
Okay. Ready? 29? Is that it? She got it.
How'd you do that?
Magic. You did it. You get the number.
I guess the number.
It was very nice meeting you.
What was your name?
Timothy.
Timothy what?
Timothy Carver. We're going to try something a little bit different here. Don't usually do this, but what's your name?
Gail.
Gail, I'm Tim. It's nice to meet
Hi.
You. Now, Gail. On a scale of 1 to 10, how good's your imagination?
Probably about a 7.
About a 7. Okay, that's pretty high. Tell you what. We're going to do a little trick with imagination.
Okay.
Okay? There's my prediction. We'll leave that right there.
Okay.
All right. Now, Gail, I want you to imagine for a moment. We'll try and keep it simple, okay? So imagine if it was just you and I.
Okay.
Only people in the room, okay? And it was a four-walled room, white walls, white floor, white ceiling, and in between us is a table.
Okay.
Simple table with a deck of cards on it.
Okay.
Okay? Now, the deck of cards is separated, reds and blacks. If you had the choice to remove one of those colors, which would you remove if you had the choice?
Black.
Black? Okay. We'll take the cards and we'll remove black, get rid of them, leaving us only with?
Red.
The red, of course. Now, the reds are separated now. There are 26 cards that are separated right down the center, 13 and 13, into two suits, right?
Okay.
There are hearts and then there are diamonds.
Mm-hmm.
Now, here's the idea. If I were to use a little bit of magic for you to absorb one of these, which would you choose?
The hearts.
The hearts? Okay. So imagine as if the hearts just floated one after the other, absorbed right to you, and they float in a perfect straight line.
Okay.
Just like this. You can see it. Ace through king. Uh-huh. Just like this. Okay? Now, if I were to cut it right down here, so we have all the number cards on this side and all the picture cards on this side, and using a little bit more magic, if I were to magically toss one of these two in the air, the picture cards or the number cards, which would I magically toss?
The number cards.
The number cards. Okay, so imagine if I took all the number cards and threw them into the air, mm-hmm. and they vanished, one after the other. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10.
Okay.
Gone. Leaving us only with the picture cards.
Right.
There are three picture cards. There's the Jack, the Queen, and the King of Hearts.
Okay.
Now, if I grab two of these, which two did I grab?
Queen and the King.
Queen and the King. Okay. And which would you like?
I'll take the Queen.
The Queen? Here you go.
Okay.
Now, here's what I want you to do. Throw the Queen of Hearts onto the table.
Okay.
Now, you said you had a number 7 for imagination. That's very high. Do you believe any of that actually happened? Do you believe your imagination was strong enough to actually put the Queen of Hearts onto the table?
Sure.
Let's see if you did.
Very good. Very good.
Okay. Well then, let's do this. Grab one. Wait, let me take my backpack off because that's like...
I'm a sucker for magic.
Enormously irritating.
This is my jam.
All right, cool. We'll do it this way. Is that a fair shuffle?
Yeah, that's good.
All right. Do you trust me?
I trust you.
Okay. Here's the idea. Reach out, grab it. Okay. Good. Got it? Do me a favor. Try and use this pen to sign your name. I'll turn around so I don't catch anything.
How are you?
Nice to meet you. Very well. Got it? Okay, cool. So you've signed your card,
yeah.
right? That way I can't switch it out or anything. But he remembers that I actually taught him some magic, and you probably didn't stick with it, but that's all right. Here's your card, all right? Or your card, rather. It's got your name on it. All right, here's the idea. Are you left-handed or right-handed?
Right-handed.
Right-handed. Hold out your hand like this. Perfect. Put your other hand on top. Like this. All right, cool. Hold it nice and tight.
Okay.
Here's the idea. If I could reach out and pull out one card, and that was your signed card, would that be amazing?
Yeah.
All right. Check this out. Ready? Let's see. Loosen up a little bit. You got death grip.
Okay.
God. All right, ready? Like this. Yeah, that's not your card. That's also a terrible joke. All right, tell you what. I'll try it again. If I could reach out and grab one card, let me see. Okay. Let's see. Is that your card? Yeah, it's got your name on it. All right, but that's not a great effect. So tell you what. I'll make the deck turn invisible, like this card here. Open your hand.
That's so cool.
I stuck with it. This is actually going to be a bit of a memory test, okay? Here's the idea. All you have to do is remember two cards. All right. First one's pretty easy. You know this card? What is it? It's five of clubs.
Clubs. Ha!
Clubs. All right. Well, I'll tell you, I can tell I'll have to go slow here, so tell you what. You've got the five of clubs.
Right.
Okay. Now, if I were to do something like this, and that card were to change, that'd be like unstinky believable, right?
Yeah.
Check it. That would have been good, though. That would have been unbelievable. Oh, my God. All right. You've got the five of clubs. And I said it's a memory test, right? You remember the five of clubs there?
Yeah.
We're going to use another card, okay? We're going to use the five of spades. Same card almost, except for, of course, the spade, right? So here's the idea. I'm going to try and switch your card with the spade.
Okay.
Watch. 1, 2. Like that. Turn it over. See, I switched it and then I put it back. That's how fast I was.
God.
You're not buying it? No? Okay. Well, if I did it slowly, you'd be able to feel it, right? When I switched the two cards, right? Now it's a memory test, right? So, here's the idea. If I put your card on the bottom, like this, which one's on top?
My card.
Is?
The five of clubs.
And which one's on the bottom?
The five of spades.
You guys clearly haven't been paying attention at all. Your memories are terrible. Turn them over.
What the heck?
Show the camera.
Whoa.
No. He has good sight of
I'm a sucker for magic.
It's awesome, isn't it? It's so much fun.
It is.